Okay, let's see. Your grammar this month is a piece of cake, okay? As I always say, extremely easy. This is your grammar. El can versus el can't, okay? Now, first, we use el can y el can to talk about abilities. For example, I can play soccer, I can play soccer, I can dance, I can jump, okay? To talk about abilities, actions that I can do. Y el can is for negative. For example, I can fly, I can teletransport, okay? Now, so, we use el can y el can to talk about abilities, okay? Actions that you are able to do in your life. Next, the second function of el can y el can is to talk about requests, okay? For example, it's hot. Uf, hot, and I say, hey, Pepito, can you open the window? And Pepito, open the window. Or for example, you are an English exam or math exam, and you say, wow, this exam is extremely difficult. Hey, can you help me? Okay, so we use el can y el can in the second function for this, to talk about requests, okay? To say, hey, can you help me? Can you open the door? Can you open the window? Hey, I'm thirsty. Can you give me a glass of water? Okay, that's the second function of el can y el can. Now, but you are in fourth secondary and fifth secondary. So let's see a complement to this grammar, because this grammar is a piece of cake. And for that, camera, come here, please. We have this, degrees of ability, okay? Or is also known as quantifiers. And here we have 5 degrees of abilities or 5 quantifiers. Here we have really well, well, quite well, not at all, y at all, 0, okay? And here I have 4 stars, 3 stars, 2 stars, 1 star, and 0 star. Listen, we use these quantifiers, these degrees of ability to say how well, how you do these abilities, okay? Let's see an example. Listen, an example, using these quantifiers or degree of ability. For example, Piqué, okay, soccer player, Piqué plays soccer really well, really well. Really well. Remember, we use these degrees of ability at the end of your sentence to say how well, how this person do the ability, the action, okay? Now, let's see another example, For example, Manuel, your math teacher, okay? Manuel can play soccer really well? Absolutely no. Well, could be, but the best option is quite well, okay? Can play soccer quite well. Okay, remember, we use the degree of ability at the end of the sentence, okay? Now, really well, well is for very good, okay? To say, hey, it's perfect, it's good. El quite well means so-so, okay? Y el not at all, y el at all is to say, no, come on, not option, okay? Let's see an example. I can fly at all. Okay? Remember, your degree of ability at the end of the sentence. I can't fly at all. There is no option. I can't fly. I can jump, but I can't fly at all. Okay? And for that, we use the degrees of ability. So, remember, El can y el can have two options, ¿ok? Function number one, to talk about abilities. Function number two, to talk about regress. For example, hey, can you give me that glass of water? Can you open the window? Can you help me? And to complement this grammar, we use the degrees of ability to say how well the person do the action, using, of course, this grammar, el can o el can, ¿no? So, you are very intelligent and you can do your homeworks in your piece of paper, but you are in 4 secondary and 5 secondary, so you are in an elite classroom. For that reason, at the end of your homework, you have 2 hypervincles, okay? You need to give a click and you will have a story. You need to read the story and answer the questions. This is a reading comprehension to increase your English level, okay? And see you later, bye!